too sick to be saved. This rare pygmy whale was carried back to the beach and euthanised with this firearm.
So we stood a metre back and everyone was standing around and a guy came over with a gun.
What happened next was too graphic to film, and some whale rescue experts say the process was careless.
Somebody should have cleared that beach way before any of that shooting was going to happen. I mean, for people to be witnessing that and to be standing so close is a really scary thought.
I turned around to the kids that I was with and I said, OK, I'd have the silencer, so just face your back and we'll be OK. And it didn't. It was really loud, so it was two loud shots into the whale.
Prior to doing anything, we confirmed everyone was happy with the safety and that people were behind a cordon.
After stranding on 90 Mile Beach, the pod was transferred to the east coast to be refloated. But the mammoth effort proved hopeless. Joe Halliday's helped at whale strandings for over three decades and says she's never seen one end like this.
I would be frightened that if that bullet had ricocheted off the bone or anything like that, those people were way too close.
The rescue operation was managed by Doc. Its adamant protocol was followed. None of the whales survived. Seven of them were shot.
A lot of the people that I spoke to were distraught and shocked, just shocked at the whole process of it.
Doc says whale strandings can be distressful and staff are visiting local schools to speak to some of the children who were on the beach that day. The department says it'll try to do a better job in the future, advising rescuers about the harsh reality of euthanasia. Helen Castles, One News.